separate the men from the bars, motherfucker. Let's go.
Niggas best verse can't collide my intro. Word yeah. Blood, daddy.
This time is for taking. Yeah. Time steady ticking. Food supply getting lower and these diapers getting expensive.
Boy, Evil Boxing Profits bringing that toe-to-toe value that's undisputed in this industry. Be sure to watch this whole video to get max value out of it. Like the video, share the video, sub to the channel too, so we can continue to bring value to the sport we all love, and that's boxing, you dig. So let's get straight to it. We headed to the middleweight division, where current franchise WBC champion Canelo, I was born scary, Alvarez and his crew are debating to have his next fight at a fucking amusement park. Can you believe it, man? They really trying to have Canelo Alvarez next fight at Never Never Land. I mean, I can't make this up. To keep it all the way 100 with you though, man, look, Canelo's next fight could be held at Mount Rushmore, according to the boxing scene, okay? Alcatraz Island or Fantasy Springs. And they go into details about it. They say Canelo Alvarez boxing exploits have been staged in the most notable areas in the United States. Exploit is absolutely correct. See, the key word in that sentence is exploit. It's because that's exactly what his whole ass is doing to the boxing game right now. You know what I mean? But they go on to say that he's a full-time, you know, champion. Oscar De la Hoya is talking about, you know, his fantasies at this spring casino and all this kind of stuff or whatever. A lot of stuff we don't really want to know about, right? But he goes on to say, this is Oscar talking, saying that, you know, that they've discussed these different locations, these different fantasy islands and Mount Rushmore and all these girly Candyland locations, right? So Eric Gomez, the Golden Boy president, you know, said that Alvarez's next fight could be staged in a ballroom, studio, or a smaller venue. Okay, well, considering the circumstances of the pandemic and the lockdowns, I certainly understand that these guys, you know, are trying their best to get creative with everything that's going on. But let me talk about this for a second, okay? Canelo Alvarez is in a position right now with Dazn where he's in dire straits, okay? I mean, we all know that Canelo came to terms with Golden Boy. He's going to get his money regardless. But at the end of the day, legacy is extremely important here, okay? And that's one thing to be a businessman, but it's also another thing to give the fans the fights we really want to see. Now, we all know the reason why Canelo Alvarez is ducking all of the smoke from the 160s all the way to the 68s, okay? He's ducking all of the smoke. He's clearly cherry-picking, I don't know how else you put it, he's clearly cherry-picking the weakest opponents out of between 60 and 68 to try to fight them. They either got to have cancer, they got to be an alcoholic, woman abuser, they got to, have feminine personalities like Julio Cesar Chavez's son does. You know, that's the guys he's targeting. Or smaller guys like Amir Khan and Josecito Lopez, right? I mean, you go down this guy's record list, okay? You know, I had Austin Trout beating him. I had Arislandi Lara beating him. Clearly, he got his ass washed out of the ring by Floyd Money Mayweather. You know, and ever since then, you know, he's just been taking all these, you know, this pussy route, you know. But that's what Oscar De La Hoya has set Canelo Alvarez up to do, right? And I don't respect it at all. So, Canelo Alvarez is in a position now where he has to deliver for the zone. He has to deliver for that platform, you know, because I'm telling you now, they're not going to renew his contract, right? So y'all mean to tell me, as young as Canelo Alvarez is right now, that he'll be out of the sport once this contract is up with Dazn? Who's going to pay Canelo Alvarez another sum total anywhere in that ballpark range? Nobody is. Nobody in their right mind. And then you got somebody who not only has been the clear cherry picker, and he's ducked all of, you know, top league competition from 160 to 168. Don't play with me, all right? Demetrius Bubu Andre is sitting right there with a belt. Why not fight him? Demetrius Andre, I'm telling you now, if the guy only made $1.5 million for his last fight or two or whatever, and only a few thousand fans showed up to his, you know, to his performance, right? I mean, I certainly didn't agree with the competition that Demetrius Bubu Andre has been, you know, coming to terms with. You know, I always wanted to see Demetrius Bubu Andre lock it up with Charlo. But here this man is sitting here with a title right now, okay? And Canelo Alvarez can just easily just beat Bubu Andre, right? I mean, Bubu Andre is so garbage. He's been fighting all these lower line competition and all this other stuff or whatever. Why you just don't come to the table right now in the middle of this pandemic, put $2 million on the table for Demetrius Andre. That's probably a lot better than any other fighter out there, you know, that's in contention, that's competitive, okay? I mean, let's keep real. I thought Chris Eubank was a good choice considering the circumstances, but I'm even going to go as far as saying that Demetrius Bubu Andre, since this man is a champion, okay? Fuck being patient. I'm tired of being patient. I'm tired of waiting on Canelo Alvarez, okay? He went all the way up to the light heavyweight division to fight a bum that's on his way out the door, right? When last time you heard from Sergey Kovalev outside of the headlines he made for you know, beating on women and things of that nature, right? A real straight pussyfied motherfucker, okay? That's just what it is. I mean, I don't understand, you know, everybody's logic about Canelo Alvarez and how he's not ducking and that these guys are ducking Canelo and that he's the money man and woo woo woo. You idiots, don't you understand that Canelo has a long history of ducking, right? He waited all the way until GGG looked vulnerable against Daniel Jacobs, right? Before locking horns with him and fighting him, okay? And I don't respect that. Not one ounce a bit, because we all know that Jacobs was coming off of his bouts with spine cancer, okay? So, you know, spend me that bullshit, okay? And everybody said that, you know, GGG looks soft, and then what do you know? Here comes Canelo Alvarez, you know what I'm saying? You know, pushing his weight around and, you know, basically, you know, made that fight. Now, like I said before, I had Alvarez beating GGG, okay? Now, you know, they have a lot of people out here that disagree with that, saying that GGG beat Canelo. I have no bones with that. I have no problem with that. But my whole thing is, and I hope y'all understand this shit, is because all y'all business-minded idiots, you know, all y'all got business degrees now, right? All y'all got your MBAs and just know all about business. Business, business, business. Business is supplying what the fans are demanding. That's business, bro. You feel me? You know, it's all supply and demand. We want to see Canelo Alvarez at least unify. When's the last time Canelo Alvarez, outside of the fight with Gennady Golovkin, when's the last time he sought after to unify the division, right? Sort of like what Jermell Charlo is doing right now in the 54s, okay? And if his brother had a shot at 168 to link horns and go with Benavidez or Caleb Plant or whoever, I'm quite 100% sure that Charlo would line up for one of those fights. They're in the PBC, so that's got to be in sometime in the near future, don't you think? And also, last thing I'm going to say about this shit with Canelo, bro, because I'm tired of going in on this dude, okay? Is, don't you think that the trilogy in 2021, that Rummy's Corner, shout out to Rummy's Corner, man, I like your video. But, you know, Rummy's Corner said that, you know, he was questioning, you know, if the fight is even going to happen in 2021. And, you know, for a big part of the reason of what's going down across the world with the Panda Lemon, right? Everybody's trying to get all fruity and creative with things. You see what Eddie Hearn is doing. I'm going to save that for another video because I'm going to go in on him too, right? But, you know, where's Gennady Golovkin in all this? Why is nobody even talking about GGG? He's over there babysitting an IBF title. Now, y'all know all this coming off of my brain. It's all coming from my heart. None of this shit is scripted. I don't even prepare for these videos, okay? I just go in speaking from my heart because I love the sport of boxing. What's wrong with that, right? What's wrong with me speaking my mind about what's going on in the sport? What's wrong with me seeing things that I don't like and speaking up on it, right? You know, we got all this bias, this and bias that and all this other crap or whatever, but can y'all please explain to me why Demetrius Andrade is sitting right there with a title, right there, 160, right? You can unify with Demetrius Andrade, right? Big bank, take little bank. Just go ahead and just take his title. Just buy it from him. You got the money. You know what I'm saying? And then go on ahead and watch GGG wipe him out of the ring in 21, and you'll be undisputed champion, and we won't be having these debates and these arguments no more. We won't be going through these crazy trivial, you know, circumstances with Canelo Alvarez and his crew at Golden Boy, right? All these questionable behaviors and feministic signals that they're talking about having fights at Never Never Land and Fantasy Land and amusement parks, you know, where there's balloons, all colors, right? Now get the fuck out of here, man. Well, anyway, let me know how you guys feel down in the comment section below. Y'all feeling the vibe that's coming from Canelo Alvarez in this camp at Golden Boy? Hit me up down in the comment section below. It's your boy, Evil Boxing Prophets. Signing out until the next one. Holla at your boy, 100. Woo!